12 seconds left. Vadney back. Up to Esposito, onside, in alone. Cheever saves! Esposito behind everybody. Moved right in. Robbed. And Cheever's made the stop. You would not believe that finish. Esposito walked in all alone, smashes his stick, and breaks it as Jerry Cheevers stoned Esposito.
Well, the Bruins were extremely lucky there, Fred. Ray Bourque had the puck at center ice. He could have just wound down the clock by taking it in the Ranger end. He elected to shoot, and Esposito came through all by himself behind the defense, and Cheevers took it away from him.
Well, they're milling around there. I don't know what the temper's frayed. Nobody's thrown a punch, but instead of going to the dressing room, they're milling around. The only one who's gone to the dressing room is Phil Esposito. After Bourque had it, went for the empty net, blocked by Greschner. Somehow they fed Esposito from the blue line in, all alone, and Cheevers, what a stop.
He made a tremendous stop. Esposito took a stick and broke it over on the glass in about three pieces, but Jerry Cheevers stood his ground. Esposito moved in, pulled the trigger. From Esposito's point of view, he did not get it as high as he would like to have. But I'll tell you, well, we got a little thing going on here between Beaton
and Secord.
As the fans are now getting involved, as O'Reilly is out into the stands, and this is going to be something. O'Reilly's into the stands fighting with a Ranger fan, and all the Bruins are going over. Gilbert is in there, Peter McNabb. They're all into the stands. McNabb's going up to grab somebody about seven or eight rows up.
Well, this is too bad that after the game is over, it gets out of hand like this. And you got to worry about a spectator.
Well, the Bruins are at a decided disadvantage, Fred, with those skates, and somebody could get seriously hurt.
Oh, this does the game no good at all, the breakout. But they fail to clear the ice at the end of the game. And all the Bruins, it seems, are over the dasher and into the stands. Terry O'Reilly was first. They were battling, and just a wild scene at Madison Square Garden.